I've been in the health system now almost 25 years. What it's done for me is give me job security, been able to work on the Central Coast, be close to home, and it allows me to have a good work-life balance. I started in health in March 1992. I was employed as a landscape gardener for the hospital. I stayed in the garden team until October 1996, where I got a position within Aboriginal Health as an Aboriginal drug and alcohol worker. So I stayed within the Aboriginal drug and alcohol work for 18, 19 years. So I progressed up to, within the drug and alcohol service, I progressed up to being the state coordinator of the Aboriginal drug and alcohol traineeship program statewide. I was able to progress into a team leader role within the drug and alcohol service as well. How did I get there? Well, it's around the education. It's around the education, the opportunities they gave me. I went to university and did a graduate diploma in Indigenous Health Promotion, which allowed me to understand more about community development and how we build the capacity within our community. And then I completed a Master's in Philosophy through Sydney University. And it was around the work I was doing as a drug and alcohol worker. The research I did in that course allowed me to work at a not at only local level, but also at a state level and on state committees on deciding what we need to do for our Aboriginal community. Since then, I was manager of, team leader of the counselling team within the drug and alcohol service. I looked after 18 staff, nurses, psychologists, clinical psychologists, social workers. So now, in March 2015, I became manager of Aboriginal Health, where I look after 8 to 9 workers here, and we've got a few different teams here. But having that career progression, which through the hospital system, where the system allows you to do that, but the key to that was actually getting an education to actually back that up. It's a very supportive service. It's a very Aboriginal-minded service, and we want to see more Aboriginal people not only grow within the workforce, but also grow within management, and also how do we get more people through the health system to help more of our community. So I know of a couple of Aboriginal workers who have progressed from their university course to actually sit within the Ministry of Health, specific Aboriginal positions. Now they're young people making decisions and guiding how Aboriginal Health should be heading into the future. Aboriginal Health has developed over the last 25 years, from my perspective, in the fact that there's a lot more workers, in key positions, a lot more services are taking Aboriginal Health seriously, a lot more services are taking responsibility for Aboriginal Health and having the workers on board to support it to do that. We have a complete system where we provide education to the hospital system around respecting the difference, which is allowing more services to understand why they work with our community. So there's really good opportunities to continue to grow. We have a lot of work to do, but I think we've moved a long way forward in the last 10 years. But we've still got a long way to go. Some of the Aboriginal positions we've seen grow over the last 10 or so years, even longer, is the Aboriginal Drug and Alcohol position, which was my position. The Aboriginal Mental Health Service have the Aboriginal Mental Health Assessment Team. The Aboriginal Youth Health Worker is now a position that's actually been very effective in the community. We have an Aboriginal Sexual Health Worker on board. We have an Aboriginal Immunisation Worker who looks at immunisation for our community. We have an Aboriginal Mothers and Baby Service in Wyong. We have an Aboriginal Mothers and Baby Service in Gosford. We have an Aboriginal Environmental Health Team. And amongst all that, we have a whole range of other Aboriginal workers based around the hospital system. And under the Aboriginal Employment Strategy that workforce has put in place, we've increased the amount of Aboriginal workers in the hospital as a whole. A lot of our community is sick, so we have a good team of people to actually provide that service and allow them to access other services and work in partnership with other services to be able to get a complete wraparound service for the patient and make sure they're looked after. So we're actually helping people not only with their own issues, but also help them with their family issues. So being able to get them through difficult times so they can actually grow as a family. And sometimes it was difficult for a lot of our community members because they lost their way, lost their Aboriginality, and so it's how do we help them get that back as well. So it's about helping people, and that's why we're in health.